Hi everyone, how do you do? Today I'm going to show you how to build a filterable calendar for dashboards. What do you think makes this dashboard unique? The only thing that makes it unique is this filterable calendar. Today I'm going to show you how to design it in Microsoft Excel. This video is a little tricky, but I promise you will love it. In these two videos, we learned how to design this dashboard. The links are in the description. But today, as I mentioned, I am going to show you how to build this filterable calendar. So let me delete it and start from very beginning. Go to the waterfall sheet and select the pivot table and add the day slicer to the sheet. By default, slicers look like this, and you can filter your list by using them. Okay, let's move it to the dashboard. From the slicer tab, set 7 columns for the slicer, like weekdays in the calendar. I want to hide the header and items with no data. To do that, click on the slicer settings and hide the header and empty items. Click on OK. In previous video, we learned how to define new style for each slicer, so apply new formatting on it. Okay, so far so good. Now you can easily filter the dashboard month by month, day by day, and even country by country. And you can also choose between dark and light themes. But we have a small problem. The day slicer doesn't act like a calendar, because when I select different months, the first day of each month starts from Sunday. We need to fix this problem. Because if you want to see the information week by week, each month must begin on the exact day. To solve this problem, we need to modify the master list data. So let's go to the master list sheet and convert the selling date format from short date to long date. Right now in the slicer, the first day of January starts from Sunday. But if you look at the first day of January, the correct day is Saturday. So I have to add 6 days before it to push the first day of January from Sunday to its exact day. To do that, select these 6 rows and insert 6 new rows. In the day column, type in these numbers and drag them down. Since I want Excel to consider these numbers as January, I have to copy the first day of January to these cells. Let me copy these 2 cells in these cells as well. Don't worry, it won't affect on your calculations, because I'm going to fill the variables with 0. To do that, select all the blank cells, and while all of them are selected, type 0 and press Ctrl Enter. Excel automatically fills all the selected cells with 0. Alright, so far so good. Let's refresh the pivot tables. Now, if you go to the dashboard sheet and select January, you can see that the first day of January starts on Saturday, which is the correct day. You might ask why I typed in these numbers. First of all, when we decrease the size of a slicer, it hides the larger content. Since my largest number in the calendar was with 2 digits, I decided to type in a number with 3 digits to hide them by decreasing the slicer size. But why they are less than 1? Because if I click on the slicer settings, by default Excel sorts numbers from smallest to largest. So it will put these numbers in the first part of the slicer, and they transform the first day of month to its exact day. Alright, now you can easily see the information week by week. Okay, let's see what happens if I filter my dashboard country by country. For example, if I select France, There is no problem, but as soon as I select another country, we have the problem again. The first day starts on Sunday. But why we don't have this problem for France? The answer to this question is in the master list sheet. If I filter the list and only show the France data, everything looks normal and helping days are here. But if I select another country, we won't have the helping days anymore. So it means we have to add the helping days for each country. Now, if I refresh the pivot tables, we don't have any problem with countries anymore. You need to repeat this process for other months as well. For example, let's do it for February. Go to the master list and press Ctrl F and search for the first day of February. Now, if I click on Find the Next, Excel navigates me to the first day of February in the list. This day starts on Tuesday, so it means I have to add two helping days to the list. And I have four countries, which means I have to add helping days for each of them as well. So I have to add 8 rows to the list and add helping days for each country. And also, you have to copy the first day of February to the blank cells. Fill the variables with 0. Now, if you refresh the pivots, you can see the correct calendar for February. Alright, I added the helping days for each month. Now, if I select different months, you can see that each month starts from the correct day. I know, it was a little advanced and maybe confusing for some of you, but I think the confusion is for those of you who haven't watched the first two episodes, because in these videos, I have explained everything step by step with details. So if you want to resolve your confusion, I suggest you to watch these videos. The links are in the description. And finally, if you think this video was helpful, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. Alright, it was all for today's video. I'll see you next video.